Thank you for joining me. This is K9 playing Sniper Elite 4. And in this mission, we're tasked with going to find the gun which you just heard fire, one of those massive guns that they put on rails during the Second World War run by the Nazis. And what I'm doing is, at this point, is a little side mission where we have to go find a secret plane and a downed American pilot. And I'm just going to take you with me and point out some things. What we're doing right here is we are a ways back from the area where Nazi troops are actually patrolling and have the area secured. And what we're going to do is we're doing our own recon and figuring out where the troops are so we can deal with them. And when you work these missions in Sniper Elite 4, it pays to actually spend some time figuring out what you're up against. You've really got to do your own recon to have guys come up from behind you and whatnot, keep the enemy in front of you. So I'm zooming the binoculars in and out. Binoculars are your B key. Zoom is your mouse wheel. I do play on the computer, and as opposed to a console system. So as I pick out more and more targets, I get closer and closer. I will tell you that keeping to the foliage, keeping under undercover is important in this game, and unfortunately
Offizier am Boden.
Unfortunately, in this game, you don't get to move very quickly when you are crouched or hidden. And I used my pistol, which is supposed to be suppressed. And timing your shots with that big gun is supposed to cover your sound, and sometimes it works and sometimes it doesn't. But notice that I'm in this foliage right next to them, and they can't see me. So cover works very well in the game. What doesn't work very well in a game sound masked. That's what you're looking for on that report, is that when that big gun fires, you want to take down your target. I held down my C key instead of going to a prone position. I stood up, which is not cool.
Hey, da ist doch etwas.
Ich bin verletzt und kann mich nicht rühren.
And I think I just gave away my position. And this is one of the tactics that work well in this game, is retreat, establish a different position, and defend your position. Since I have given my position away, I'm going to work on protecting myself and just taking down the competition. Okay, they obviously know what your position is. Change it. Like I said, moving means standing up in this game. Sticking to the shadows does work well. Go ahead and stick your head out there, see what happens to you. They know where I'm at, so I'm going to change position, sticking to the shadows. And he just threw a grenade, so I'm going to move. If you're watching my health over in the lower right-hand corner, I need a med kit. Have one loaded up. I'm going to hit my F key, hold it down until the med kit is used, and recharge my health. So, supposed to be stealthy. Didn't pull that one off on this one so far. But notice my icon on my mini-map in the lower left-hand corner is green, which means I'm not currently being hunted by somebody. So. I'm all right, as long as you take down the guys that are chasing you, you're all right. I would think that the AI on the NPCs would have more people converging on the shots fired, but they tend to mind their own business outside of maybe a couple hundred meters or so. So, let me see here. I'm going to hold down my Q key. Change not to my med kit, because if you hit the F key inadvertently, it consumes one of those, and they're kind of important. You can always pick one up when you need one. So I'm going to go to the little rocks, which there's an infinite supply of. And here's some of the other things that I'm going to do, is that on the way back to where I'm moving to, I'm going to, key element in this game, hold down my E key, search the corpse, and pick up some rifle ammo and some other things that this person might have been carrying, because you cannot call in supplies from your support. You have to make do in the field. You can resupply at the beginning of the mission, but that's about it. And notice I'm picking up a lot of stuff from these guys, so that's what you want to do on these missions with in Sniper Elite 4, is you want to pick up the stuff off the guys that you drop and make a habit of it, make a point of it. There was an officer that we dropped, and I don't know that I found him. I want to go back and find him. Officers sometimes
no more
have
to find here.
Other things. Oh, there he is. I knew he was right in front of the bush I was hiding in. Duty roster, pistol ammo. Duty rosters unique to him. You get extra points for him, I think. And there's a couple other guys. dropped back in here. Over in the distance, that's the duty roster that actually highlighted those guys. Once I found the duty roster, I find not only who people are, what ranks they are, but where they're located, where their assignments were. That's why the highlights come up without me actually seeing them over there in the distance off over my head. The guys with three stripes are officers. Those are prime targets, and for some of the missions, they are assigned targets. Note that the officers will blow a whistle, call guys together, get them organized and on your tail. So if you drop them first, they tend not to organize very well. Key points that I've learned so far. I'm gonna step up here on the high ground and see if I can actually...
It's one of our recon planes. It's a prototype. The Nazis can't be allowed to analyze that wreckage. Gotta destroy it, somehow.
Which means, after I think the second mission, you get what's called a satchel charge. They are unlimited in their supply, and considering how large and heavy satchel charges are, I find that a little surprising. But in the game, you get an unlimited supply of satchel charges, and they will be highlighted when you come up to what you can put them on. That is another one of our targets, I believe. There is a heavy vehicle. Yep, there it goes down there.
That truck's carrying ammo. Have to stop it.
And couldn't move quickly enough to actually get it. And I'm being looked at from our side over there. Missed it. I thought it was the armored car. Oh, well. So, I'm going to take, I'm going to line up this officer. Crap. Okay, I could take him down now, but my shot isn't masked, and that's what I want. Is before I get all five of these guys keyed in on my position, I want to wait for that gun to fire and hopefully have him lined up, unlike now, he's behind some trees. I want to have him lined up so that when that gun fires, I can drop him and they won't know where the shot came from. Zooming in and out with this scope that's on your rifle is done by the mouse key, so I'll push the right. I shot. Nope. That was not masked. I thought I got that off pretty quickly, and... first shot off pretty quickly after the cannon, and apparently it was not masked. The sound was not masked. But despite that, this is actually going pretty well. You can't hold that shot for a while. And again, I'll review this with you. Right click. You right click to hold. You right click to get your sight going. And then you mouse wheel in on your target and you hold your base bar to go with the empty lung shot to empty your lungs of air, which allows you to which allows you to hold very still while you're trying to make that shot. Masking at this point doesn't make a lot of sense. The detail at which they actually illustrate those kills specifically by what's going on in where your NPC is, what angle he's at, where you're firing from, where the shot hit him, etc., and the fact that they actually illustrate that in detail is an amazing part of this game. Very gruesome, but amazing, nonetheless. And I've eliminated all the threats. So on the way back to
this target... Can't find anything else.
On the way back to this target, I am going to pick up all the supplies that I can. Getting over here, I wasted some pistol ammo. I don't think I fired my submachine gun. But I did fire my rifle, which is my main weapon.
Nothing else.
Bandage is good to have. Med kit for a lot of damage repair to yourself. Bandage for a little bit of a damage. Officers are always good to search. Duty roster again. And a collectible of some type. Not him. It's not that the bodies don't have something that you could use, but they don't have something that you can use that you're not full capacity on. So if you're full capacity on pistol ammo, it may not show that you've got something to work with here. Oh, these are of significance. I didn't see that through the binoculars or I would have pinged it. This will mask your shot when you actually interact with these, either by right-clicking on it, coming up to here and right-clicking, and getting it to misbehave, or if you can get within range of your sound-dampened pistol. It'll start making all kinds of noise, and that'll dampen or mask the sound of your shot. So look for those in the environment at which you are shooting. You can do that in your own environment, but by the time the round gets to where it's going, having that little engine freaking out in your environment, far away from where you're planting that shot, isn't really going to do a whole lot. And this little glowing impression here that's right in front of me is the satchel charge. You can put a satchel charge right there. You walk up to this thing, you hit R, and then another R to put a timer on it or a fuse. And you want to get out of the area because it will kill you. But that's the mission. Destroy that wreck so the Nazis can't actually analyze the secret plane.
That's the wreck dealt with.
Okay, so that is this side mission of the main mission, and I'll just stop the video here for you, letting you know that's how to get this side mission done, and head about going on to the main mission and make that another video or so. Okay, so that's how to actually find the plane and deal with the guys around it. So I will hopefully talk to you again soon. K9 out.